Thanks to Speakly for sponsoring today's video. All war is deception, said the ancient Chinese tactician Sun Tzu. And so perhaps it's unsurprising that the planet Mars, titled after the god of war, is quite the deceiver. Optical illusions and trickery have been part of Mars's story since the 1800s, when astronomer Giovanni Schiaparelli first looked through his telescope and saw canals crisscrossing the planet's surface, hinting at advanced alien life. The only problem? No such canals existed. They were phantasms, an apparition. Sometimes, trusting your own eyes is a dangerous thing. The Perseverance rover in our own time has its work cut out for it. It's a successor of Schiaparelli, continuing the hunt for signs of life on Mars, except this time it travels across the surface of the planet itself. And certainly, it succeeded. It has photographed images of advanced technology on Mars, but the Red Planet has a long history of deceiving us, and not everything is what it appears to be. What is the trick, and what is the reality? I'm Alex McColgan, and you're watching Astrum. Join with me today as we look at some of the strange objects Perseverance has imaged on the Red Planet that caused us to make sure our eyes weren't playing tricks on us. In the sixth video in this series on this incredible rover, covering May 2022 to September of that same year. Perseverance had entered an exciting time in its journey in May. Its mission had finally taken it to the Jezero Crater Delta, the location scientists were the most optimistic about finding signs of ancient alien microbial life, hopefully buried in layers of ancient silt and clay from a massive dried-out river. A discovery of even rudimentary life in such a place would be mind-blowing. It would completely revolutionize our understanding of our place in the universe, and would vastly increase the probability that we are not alone. Discovering organisms that were more advanced than bacteria would be orders of magnitude more earth-shattering, particularly if we found something intelligent, as Schiaparelli once thought he'd discovered. And so, Perseverance attempted to collect cores and photograph abrasions from locations such as Enchanted Lake, Three Forks, and Hawksbill Gap. It didn't have an easy time of it initially. Many of the rocks it encountered, such as the ones in the Devil's Tanyard area, proved to be extremely crumbly and broke under the force of Perseverance's abrasion drill, or had surfaces that were too rough to even begin the attempt. It wasn't until July that Perseverance was able to successfully take its first core sample from the Delta, from a rock named Skinner Ridge. But in the next few months, as it traveled from location to location, it began to image things from a distance that looked decidedly out of place. Namely, in September, it spotted a cat. This was not a real cat, of course, but simply a somewhat cat-shaped rock formation. In my opinion, it's quite the rough comparison, but many people were amused by this feline fake-out loafing in the Martian sun, with the image making the rounds on different media outlets at the time. I was more impressed at the image of the snakehead that Perseverance captured earlier in June. You can almost see the creature's eye here, as it tastes the thin Martian atmosphere, perhaps looking for a treat to eat. Like a snake on the hunt, or perhaps a lurking moray eel. Such illusions are easy enough to recognize as illusions. I don't think anyone truly believes that there are snakes or cats lurking in Mars's arid deserts. But moments like this have an important connection to another rock formation scientists found on Mars back in 1976, when the line between illusion and groundbreaking discovery became a lot more blurred. It's one thing to find a rock outcropping that sort of looks like a cat. It's another thing when your orbiter takes a photo of a 2 kilometer long image that looks perfectly like a human face, right there on the Martian surface. What do you think when you see this image? Maybe this is something someone made on Photoshop? But the crazy thing is, this image is absolutely real, and was taken by the Viking 1 orbiter nearly 5 decades ago. It was released to the public by NASA, and naturally set theorists ablaze with speculation as to its origins. Could something that seemed to mirror our own features so perfectly really be a naturally forming coincidence? If not, who had built it? A long-lost civilization that perished on Mars millennia ago? An alien race that later traveled to Earth and became our ancestors? Theories abounded. So much so that NASA scientists felt it important to go back to the area and image the location a second time. They did so in 1998, and again in 2001 with the Mars Global Surveyor. We now have high-rise images of the location. Thanks to the much better cameras available on these newer orbiters, the true dimensions of the face on Mars could be mapped out much more clearly. What was revealed was less distinctive than the original shadowed image. While it's still technically possible that the face on Mars was once much more distinctive, but has simply had its features smoothed down by weathering, it seems more likely that we can chalk this one up to a human tendency known as pareidolia. Pareidolia is the habit we have of seeing recognizable images in actually quite random visual patterns. For instance, have you ever looked at a cloud and spotted something that looked recognizable? A person, or an animal, or a car? Pareidolia has been with us since ancient times. It is thought to be an evolutionary trait. If there's some lurking predator hiding in the undergrowth, being able to identify it as such with only a few visual cues is extremely useful. The downside of this is that sometimes we see meaning where there honestly is none. A man out of the corner of our eye, but there's no one there when we turn. A message in our cereal bowl. A face on Mars. Our minds are never unbiased and are constantly interpreting the visual stimuli we take in, trying to piece the world together in a way that makes sense. This can be a great aid to us, helping us identify important patterns in data. However, we have to be very careful with it, as it can also be a hindrance if it ever leads us to jump to conclusions that later turn out to be untrue. Sadly, when it comes to Mars, not all illusions are based on untruth. Perseverance's next discovery is 100% factually accurate. Back in April 2022, Perseverance started imaging strangely bright-colored objects in the delta's distant terrain as it passed by. These objects were something of an enigma. Scientists weren't sure what they were, only that they were perhaps roughly 15 centimeters in size. They named the bright material, and called it a day. Hopefully, Perseverance would be able to get a closer look later. Later arrived in June, when Perseverance finally imaged something. It was definitely not a rock formation. It was silvery in color, very thin, with a routine pattern across its surface. It was clearly artificial in nature. And it wasn't alone. Within the next few months, Perseverance also imaged a tangled ball of string, and even some netting. Half a dozen such pieces were recorded in the area, with these the creation of a race of technologically advanced entities thousands of years old. Yes, but sadly, just not an alien race. They were from us. Scientists were quickly able to identify all of these objects as either being part of the entry, descent, and landing system, or the sky crane that had lowered Perseverance onto the planet all the way back in February 2021. The silver material was a thermal blanket and had been part of the spacecraft that had brought Perseverance down through the atmosphere of Mars. The string and netting were likely Dacron netting, which was also part of the spacecraft and sky crane's insulation. Both sets of material had clearly been torn apart by strong forces. There's a curious facet to this, however. It was a little surprising to find these materials here. Perseverance's landing was roughly 2.5 kilometers to the southeast of this location. Skycrane had presumably landed somewhere nearby. And while the parachute and parts of the spaceship had come away earlier, and so had landed at a more distant site, these had already been found. Ingenuity had taken photos of the downed parachute and parts of the spacecraft roughly 1 kilometer northwest of the landing site. that still left approximately 1.5 kilometers of additional distance the material had to travel. In the end, the solution to this question was simple. The wind was to blame. Over the 1.5 years that Perseverance had been traveling around the planet, taking samples and abrading rocks, the shifting Martian wind had taken debris from the crash site of Perseverance's spacecraft and had slowly but surely been migrating it across the planet. It is a testament to the relentless nature of Mars's winds and the fact that there is no one on Mars doing litter collection. This discovery was a splash of cold reality on Perseverance's mission. While this mystery was solved, it suddenly meant that there was a chance, however small, that cross-contamination was going to be an issue going forward. If debris was traveling across the planet in the direction Perseverance was heading in, then there was a chance that if that debris carried a small, hardy bacteria that had somehow survived the trip from Earth, it might throw off the results. Fortunately, such a chance was reassuringly small. Not only did NASA work hard to keep Perseverance free from contamination during construction, making use of clean rooms to keep bacteria and dust out, even if something from Earth did find its way into a sample tube, scientists would likely be able to recognize it as such. Still, scientists would be careful going forward of contamination or of getting debris stuck in the rover's parts. Perseverance's mission goes on. In its effort to uncover the truth, it will have to uncover the tiniest of details. However, what I've come to realize is that one of the biggest hurdles it must overcome is us. It is almost impossible to completely remove bias from ourselves, and yet biases can cause us to interpret data in such a way as to allow ourselves to be fooled by tricks and illusions. Although NASA was quick to recognize the artificial materials as their own, it would have been easy for someone with less rigor to try to connect such discovery to alien technology. After all, the temptation is surely there. The person who proved alien life existed would forever go down in the history books. But without taking time to double check that what we want to see isn't clouding what we are seeing, we might go down in history for a very different reason. Nobody wants to be famous for being the person who saw aliens when they were only rocks and debris in a crater, after all. Is English your native language? Did you stumble when I referred to the alternate meaning of attitude earlier? Luckily, if you want to get a better grasp of English, or if you already are an English speaker like me and want to learn something new, there is an app I use called Speakly that is available on both web and mobile that helps you master new languages up to 5 times faster than other methods you might be familiar with. It does this in a really clever way. Its polyglot creators have identified the key vocabulary you need to converse, and so focus its daily activities on helping you master phrases you'll actually need in day-to-day life. As someone who's had experience learning other languages, this relevant learning is really useful for me. I found its user interface really easy to navigate, and practicing speaking in its live situations felt very natural. And if you try it out now, there's a 7-day free trial, so there's no risk in giving it a go. If you like what you see, there's even a 60% discount on their annual subscription. Click on the link in the description below to give it a try.